PowerDirector 16, how do we rotate an image? You can even do this with image in image. You can do this with your logos. Rotating things inside the PowerDirector window is quite easy. So let's get into this. Grab whatever video or image, it really doesn't matter, and pull it down into your timeline. I'll spread this out so that way we can see a little bit more of it. Now, you can double click on this and go into the PIP designer, or you could click on designer and go into PIP right here. So it's up to you. Double click it, enter PIP designer. Now, if you don't see this at the bottom here, what I've done is move your mouse up and down and you'll see it finally put the actual crosshairs on it. See that? And if you don't see that, then it's because this window hasn't been highlighted or activated, I guess would be the best way to say it. You notice nothing pops up there. I can't get it to pop up. I don't have that line. So if I click here in the gray area, now I've activated the windows and you'll see where these actually popped in. But now you can pull down and you'll see how I've got everything working now. You may end up seeing something like this and not even see it. So what you really want to do is pull that up and then you can see everything that's going on over here. And also under properties, we want to go into object settings on this side. So the first thing I'm going to do, and now I call it activating, which is a keyframe. We want a keyframe to show up under rotation is where we want one. So right off the bat, I'll click that triangle. Boom, it created a red keyframe right there. Now, you can do this by hand or you can type numbers in. I can literally type numbers in this box here or I can do this by hand. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this down to say, I don't know, 50%. So the image is sitting in a smaller box. On the timeline itself, I'm going to click here. That's it. Now that green dot there, see that green dot? We're going to twist this to the left. And we'll leave it there. Boom. It dropped the keyframe in there for us automatically. I'll move it across again. I'll grab it again and move it around. And it's going to put another keyframe right there. And again, I just repeat the process over and over. And that's going to give us this really cool animation, which is what it's going to make for us. Now, if I want to do a complete spin, which I'm going to do here at the end, but first, I guess I'll put it there, and I'll have it straighten out first. And then I'll go here, and then here's where I'm going to drop a keyframe in. Boom. It's the red one. And then in this box here, I'll type 1080, and you can type different numbers in there, whatever you like. So now you'll see how I've done all this. Now I'll put it to 100%. I'll say OK, and it should save it. And when it runs through, it'll give me that back and forth look, and then it should give me a couple spins around when it reaches the end. So there you go. And that shows you how to actually turn an object and move it around. So again, when you're in your PIP designer, and you're in the rotation under object over here, this is where you play with everything. Now I could even go a little deeper into this. I mean, I could go into motion and then I could say which way I want it to rotate. Okay, and then I can even set like a path if I wanted to squiggle in type of thing. So I could really mess with this now and really get playing with it. So I've kind of got it dancing apart, going across the screen. And you can really get kind of crazy with it there. So I would say go and load yourself a video. Go into your PIP designer. And go into your object settings. And then actually go down into your rotation part. And just play with that little triangle there, which is a keyframe. And then shrink it down and then move it around. And when you get comfortable with it, then actually go into your motion settings. And you can play around with these a little bit. And this will actually get you used to playing with keyframes within NetObjects. this will actually get you to the first steps of actually messing with them a little bit. And I'm going to have more tutorials on keyframes. So this will actually get you guys to the point where we're starting to understand them. Again, you're going to go into your PIP designer. Okay. You're going to go into objects. And if I close that real quick, just to make sure, we're going to go into our objects. And then you're actually going to go down and mess with your rotation. And this is where you're going to mess with everything in here. And don't forget to pull this up so you can see what's going on. We have a lot of other choices in here of tutorials we're going to have later, guys. So in PowerDirector 16, if you want to mess with your objects, your videos, your images, add some dance to it, go check it out on the rotation. And hey, guys, I'll catch you guys on the next one.